Envision you have a large closet with a million drawers, and I put an item into one of the drawers. Please find this item. If this would be a quantum processor, 1,000 operations would be enough to find this item with certainty. It's rather amazing. I'm the director of engineering here at Google and the lead of the Google AI Quantum Lab. We try to lift up the whole capability of quantum computing from the atoms all the way to the bits in the algorithms. A classical bit, you get a 0 or 1. When you read out a qubit, the projection of this vector on the unit sphere will give the probability with which you get the 0 or 1. The qubit can be in a mix of both of these states at any given time. It gives us access to a richer set of operations. The question is natural to ask, hey, are there any commercially important tasks we can do with our processors today? There are applications in generative machine learning, computing spectra of molecules. If we had already an error-corrected quantum computer, we would be able to do important calculations that pertain to COVID. We focused on developing a 1 million physical qubit quantum computer. Our joke is to lean on the Kennedy quote and say we will do it before the end of the decade. In quantum computing, connectivity is essential. Quantum information has provided a common language to fields in physics that usually didn't talk to each other. Physicists might not understand the intricacies of a chemical like chemists, but if it's framed in terms of qubits and interacting spins, oh, that's what you're doing. Quantum information provides this lingua franca that bodes very well for innovation. I'm convinced that the best applications have yet to be discovered.